everyone. Welcome to Quilt Talk Tuesday. This is Anna. She's my little schnoodle. She loves to sit on my lap and help me when I want to sew. But anyway, my name is Tina Dillard, owner of Quilting Affection Designs, and welcome to my design studio. I hope you are staying warm today. It is warmer here today. It's probably in the upper 30s. We're supposed to get some snow tonight, and that's going to be wonderful for the morning commute tomorrow. It's going to make a mess. I hear Texas is complaining about the cold weather down there being in the 30s. I'm sorry, you guys, but we've been colder. Well, this week I've been really busy in my sewing studio. I've been working on setting up a new camera system for these live streams. And with my help of my oldest son, Patrick, who just got back, he is here to do my AV for me. It's wonderful to have some little help in around the studio. Also, I've been preparing for a trunk show at my local quilt guild tomorrow night. That's been a lot of prep work. At least I don't have to travel very far to go to the meeting. It's just down the road. Also, if you would like to have me come and lecture at your guild, please see the link in the description and let me know. I'm scheduling for 2018, 2019, so let me know what you want me to work. I can work your schedule. Today, I would love to hear any of your questions or just comments or ideas for upcoming live posts. You have something you want to learn? Let me know. And go ahead and post them. I'll answer as many as possible during the live feed or at the end. Now to get into a little bit of quilting. This last week, I started a new blog series. I've started a challenge for myself. I'm doing a 2018 challenge, Master the Rulers. This blog is on the goals, one of my long-term goals of becoming a certified instructor for Deb Tucker 180 Designs. I love these rulers and all the techniques that Deb has come up with. I am currently, one of my newest quilts, Rambling Star, which I'll be talking about in a couple more weeks, will cover these rulers. So I really, really love these rulers and recommend them. So I wanted to do is perfect my skills to become a certified instructor for these rulers. So I designed a blog series based off the Blockbuster series they've done on their website. And you can find these on their website. The Blockbuster series is using a ruler, Studio 180 ruler, or a technique sheet they have, or a combination of the both. Series 1 has 15 blocks. Series 2, which came out last year, has 10 blocks. And Series 3, which comes out, I think, this month, in January, will be out shortly. You can find the link for Series 1 and the description in the description area of this video on Facebook. Last week, I completed the very first one, Block 1, which is the Ohio Star variation that uses the Tucker Trimmer 1 ruler. What you're going to do is use these sheets that you print out, you can print out, or you can just follow online with them. And they have a description. They have a picture of the block broke out into different units. And then down below, they have a cutting chart. And I don't know if you could see this, but in the cutting chart, it has units. It lists the different units, which are labeled in here on your diagram sheet area. And it gives you the number of units you will need and the block area sizes, which is finished and cut size. For a 6 inch, a 12 inch, and a 15 inch. Now, depending on which Blockbuster you're doing, each one will have a different one. So, you will do is from this cutting chart, you'll notice that you need to cut 2 inch. You need to have a finished size for the quarter square triangles, 2 inch size. So that's where you need to have your Tucker Trimmer 1 instructions. They have charts in here that list what size you need to use for your quarter inch squares. So we need a it was a 2 inch finished size. So we do is about a 3 inch you will need to cut. Just you just then follow the instructions, which are very clear on the ruler instructions, how to put the quarter inch squares together. It's very easy. She does all the work for you. All you have to do is follow the instructions and put the blocks together. So my block, which came out to be a 6 inch block, and I'm using the Island all my scraps of my Island Batiks to make these blocks. It comes out to have you're going to have half square triangles and quarter square triangles with some squares, and you're going to put these blocks together. And I can show you the back. It's very clean looking, and it's ready to go if you were going to put it into a quilt. And it measures 6 by 6, unfinished. Well, finished. So sorry, finished. So remember, every Friday I will be doing a new blog post. This is going to be a fun project for me, and it's going to be learning too, because some of the rulers I haven't played with, and I really want to play with them. I've ordered what I can ahead of time, and they should be coming any day for me to start working on I can start my next block, but I can't do the next one because I need the tools. And if you want to join me, let me know. Leave a comment on the Facebook for me that you want to join in. I will set up a link party, and we'll share our blocks together, what we have done. Now I want to talk about is my what I really wanted to talk about today was the machine maintenance. And I think this is a very important topic because we need to have a smooth running machine at all times so we can keep working on those wonderful quilt projects. I have two machines, a Janome 7700 and a Bernina 580. This is my main machine. And each one of them has a little different maintenance to it. And so you should refer to your own user manual that came with your machine. So, my suggestions is to clean between your projects. Clean machine really well. Get all the lint, change the needle, make it happy. So you can keep going. Before you start, make sure your machine is unplugged. which I double checked and it is still unplugged, and the foot control is unplugged. Never use alcohol, petrol, or any solvents to clean your machine. Don't use canned air. This will leave moisture on your components, and you don't want your components rusting out. And they will rust out if you get too much. I've seen different pictures of them online. If you do, what happens? And it's really recommended, and I've talked to several of my store people, and they really recommend not using canned air. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and go through and clean my machine, get it ready to go. So first thing I'm gonna do is take my plate off. And then I'm gonna take and remove my presser foot and needle. This is a good time to replace your needle, because you want a sharp needle. You can miss stitches if you don't. Just make sure you change your needles. Put these to the side. Now we're gonna open our bobbin door. And if you can see, my machine is pretty dirty. And I'm now gonna take and remove the stitch plate. I just gotta pop it back and pop it off. And you can see, it's really, really dirty. I haven't done my machine because I've been back-to-back project the last couple of times. So I've decided this is the time to clean my machine. I'm gonna take this thread off my machine and just set it to the side so we don't have that in the way. What you're gonna do is use your lint brush. Don't use anything else. Use a lint brush. You can buy a brand new paintbrush and use it as your lint brush if your machine doesn't have one that works. So we're gonna start from the feed dog area, and I'm hoping you guys can see this, and we're just gonna wipe around and then get into the feed dogs and clean that machine. Now you can see that I'm getting lint on my, lint brush. I like to keep used batting from my long arm, and these make great dust cloths when you're out in your sewing room. And I just take the lint brush and wipe it on the batting. And that cleans that off. Now I'll go back and I'll finish cleaning this. You want to make sure you really get down there and push all that lint away. Now some of you on your machines may have to pull your bobbin out already. I haven't done that, so I'm going to go ahead and do that, because we're ready to start below. Now, for your bobbin case, take your thread out, and you're gonna want to then clean inside here and get all the dirt and grime that comes off your thread off your bobbin case. If you have to pull this ring out, you can pull it out. And then put this to the side. You don't need it right now. Now you're gonna get down there and you're gonna finish cleaning all the around the hook assembly. Get in there, clean that dirt. Once you get all of that off, look around your area. You'll notice you have a lot of lint. Pull that out. Start pulling some of that out. Get it away. And we'll pile it right here for now. And you'll make a mess on the outside of your machine. Well, that's better than being inside your machine. And I take another one of these cloths, and I'm gonna wipe this down. This is where the eye that sees my bobbin to see how full it is and lets me know when it's empty. And then I will take this cloth, this batting cloth, which is great, and just wipe around the door area. And I see some more lint that needs to be removed from the top. You want to start from the top and work down so it just falls down. And you have a clean inside of your bobbin case area. So now you just put everything back together and just pop that stitch plate in. This could be a little loud. Sorry. And put your presser foot back on. And when you're ready to sew, go ahead and put a new needle in. And you can put your bobbin case back in. Just slide it back in. Push that open. Prepare the thread. Close the door. Now, you also want, before you get started sewing, is to clean around the area. Wipe it off so you don't get any lint on your quilt. Wipe back here. Wipe around the machine. You may want to once in a while move your machine. You'll have tons of lint underneath that also. And you can see you have lots of lint. You need to remove that because it'll get gummed up in your machine and you won't be able to sew. Speaking of that, you'll need to, depending on your machine, lubricate. This came with my Bernina, this oil, and my machine lets me know when to lubricate. Now, it depends on your machine, so look at your user manual to lubricate your machine. Some machines don't want it. I've seen several machines that don't. Just remember to check your manual. Service. My service is coming due, I think, in March, April time frame. That's when I bought my machine. So each year on the anniversary, I take her in for cleaning. That's her birthday present to my machine to say, I love you and I want to keep you. This makes your machine really, really happy because they'll open it up and they will clean inside completely for you. Because you'll find there's places you can't get to on the machines that will get lint build up. Talk to your machine, where you bought your machine, and ask them, when do you want me to bring my machine in? Most of them will recommend each year, depending on how much you use your machine. If you use it really a lot, then you may want to bring it in a little sooner. Some you may want to just wait another year. But service is really good for your machine. Have we gotten any comments? I don't think we have. But if you have comments after this video and you want suggestions for video, different kinds of videos, what do you want to learn? Do you want me to show you how to use the Tucker Trimmer 1 or some of the other Studio 180 rulers? I'll be willing to help you out. If you do, leave me some comments, even if after the video has been posted. And I will help you out. I'll comment back and let you know. So I want to thank you for stopping by Quilt Talk Tuesday, and we'll see you next week. And please share these videos or any of the posts I have on Facebook. This will help keep my Facebook feed going, and you'll be able to see some of my beautiful quilts coming up. Have fun quilting, and we'll see you next week. Bye.